Hey man, how's it going? You've been listening already. How's it going? So, big dilemma, right? Do you listen to the funky tunes on High Spirits Radio? Or do you, in fact, go back to listening to the Video Wizards podcast? It's all up to you. Either way, you win, in my book. Good stuff. Between you and me, since you're the only one here in the chat, I sort of pulled an all-nighter to get the edit on the Video Wizards podcast done. This stuff takes so much time. It's so much fun, but it also takes so much time. So around 6 o'clock, I exported the audio file and sent it over to Ben. And then I hit the sack, and then I got up at 9 again to start working. And I'm still doing good up until now. Spirits are high because of this music, of course. Yeah, I mean, I really, it's even just for myself, I just wanted to get it out. We're really striving for that first Monday of the month. Just have that a rule set in stone that we release a new one every first Monday of the month so people can count on that. So we got some Billy Ocean and some Paul Hardcastle coming up this afternoon, because they're in the April 1986 podcast. And yeah, got especially for the Paul Hardcastle song that was charting in April 1986, got a bit of an appreciation for it. It definitely fits into the mold of what I regularly play on here. Good, huh? That era had a lot of really powerful vocalists. I don't want to sound like that old man, like they don't sing like this anymore. They really don't sing like this anymore. They really don't. I'm sorry. I can't change that. That's it, yeah. Freaking Will Smith, man. Just jacking songs like that wholesale. Not even being creative with it. It started out good with DJ Jesse Jeff and the Fresh Prince. Yeah, definitely. Great tune. I getcha. Oh yeah, definitely. All us hardcore hip-hop heads used to hate his guts. He was the devil. He wasn't keeping it real. Nowadays, I'm not so militant, but yeah, you won't catch me listening to that, to any of that. That late 90s bad boy stuff. It was Puff Daddy and Will Smith, actually, that were the worst for this. Then you had Jermaine Dupri also a little bit, but... I mean, I didn't like his music, but there was more original compositions there than rather just taking songs wholesale and doing them over. Yeah, I think he would maybe be flattered by the sentiment, but that's about it. Yeah, that I'll be missing you. I mean, Puff Daddy had no business rapping and being in music videos anyway. He was a business guy. He was a label executive. He had no rhyming talent. Yeah, his musical talent. He had a team of producers, the Hitmen, who would sometimes put out really great beats and great tunes. But also, they would just go the cheap route and just jack a popular song of yesteryear. Don't get me started. Don't get me started. Here we go, Billy. The Ballad of Billy Ocean. Oh, this song was so big in April 86. So I have no idea how this album is. Could be garbage. But let's discover it together. Yeah, we totally forgot to mention that on the podcast, of all the things we did mention. Jewel of the Nile. This was for Jewel of the Nile. With Michael Douglas. Bit of an Indiana Jones knockoff, right? So Ben always mishears the lyrics on this song in a very amusing way. I'm not gonna spoil it. But if you didn't do that before, you can never unhear it again. Oh yeah, the first film was Romancing the Stone, right? Totally forgot that. That's a series of movies. Yeah. We've got an ocean, we've got a hard castle this afternoon. Are you picturing the scene? So, on the new Video Wizards podcast, we're talking about the fantasy zone, right? Well, Billy Ocean, he'd rather be in the love zone. The love zone, not the fantasy zone. Because that's what this album is called, and that's also what this song is called. Let's hear it. Let's hear it for Billy. Love zone. Exciting and new. No, different song. I don't know about where you are right now, but I'm definitely in the love zone. Very much so. Did he sing that? I think he sings "You don't have to be alone" in the love zone. Otherwise, this would be a very masturbatory song. Ha! What a masturbatory song. Totally self-indulgent, this song. All alone in the love zone. Billy got a 9 there on the ballot scale, if not a 10. We don't go for that. He sang "Hiya." He's on his Billy Bear Hands ballad shit now. Hiya! I know karate. Billy's sweet. Billy Sweet. You got me dancing and turning. Nobody else would ever do. But I want you, baby. Sweet like Billy. My name's Billy and I'm so sweet. Billy Sweet. I think Billy is driving down to Funky Town right now. That sounds more like it. Showdown. A funky showdown. But in a funky showdown between Billy and, say, George Clinton, I think he loses it. Yeah, you've got to. I think we need to play this song tomorrow when me and Leon are showing down in San Conor on the 2 again. Who's gonna win? And who's gonna lose? That was good, right? Probably sounds terrible when I hear it back again. That's not what it sounds like in my head. Is it just me, or am I getting Metroid vibes from this this melody? Getting very heavy Metroid vibes all of a sudden, like Super Metroid, Metroid Prime. This less so, but that little melody before, yeah. This one's called King Tut, but I feel like I'm on a different exotic planet all of a sudden. She's talking about "I've heard all your lies," so maybe she's singing this to Billy Ocean. Goodbye, don't waste my time. I think Billy's got problems. She's onto his lies. And he can apologize all he wants. But she sees right through him. Billy Ocean, don't waste my time with your ballads. Don't waste my time.